We had 278 dance poses for 13 other moves and their variations, and they were represented using this dance position vector. So our first task was model the body, represent this adabus and save them and make a database of existing adabus. This was done. Next. Now after that, next was to generate innovative poses. Next. So what we did, the first obvious is brute force method. Let's see what happens if we use the brute force method. Now we have the dance poses and we have it 6 limbs. We have the Shirobheda, the right hand, the left hand, waist, right leg and left leg. And I have shown you that how many positions are available for each, if you can see. Okay, so many combinations are available. Next. Now, if we make a direct combination of all these, next slide, we get 8.6 into 10 raised to 18 possibilities. So many possibilities, which any dance teacher also cannot remember or understand or could have even imagined. That so many possibilities, and this we are calling for only one single beat. Dance is not a single beat, but just to know what is the power of a computer to get so many possibilities. All of these possibilities are either not physically possible or not aesthetically pleasing or not following Bharatanatyam norms. So we have to filter them down. For example, when you are on only on 2 toes, then it is a ballet movement. We don't want it in classical Bharatanatyam, so we have to eliminate that. Or for example, both the hands are back. Is possible combination? It is not a pleasing dance movement. So like that, we have to sit and eliminate all this combination by manually sitting with experts and doing this task. It was a very Herculean task. It took me a long time to come to that. Of course, my knowledge of dance helped, but I wanted to authenticate it with the dance teachers as well. So we have pruned those movements. Now, then we used genetic algorithm.
This is good news. I appreciate your efforts in doing it manually. But why not you
have
thought of
supervised
learning in that case?
How could we use supervised learning to...
Plenty
of research topics which will come up now. Plenty. Yeah, so then we used a genetic algorithm to find out, to determine the appropriateness of the dance steps by modeling it through a fitness function. So we randomly generated 2000 dance position vectors, of course after filtering out with those possibilities, and select 10 as the initial population. And then we create 6 crossover points, because we have 6 major limbs of the body, as we said, head, right hand, left hand, waist, right leg, left leg. So we created crossover points for that.
So at the time you
are changing
all 6 positions?
Just let me finish this, no? So we are changing. So head can be changed crossover only with head, because head has certain attributes. Yes. So after creating all this, yeah, let's go. Mortho, it's not pure. So one more research talk. I know you will find plenty of them there. So, huh? No. So yeah, remaining for all the 5 limbs, we found them out, and then we find the initial seed population. And similarly, crossover and mutation is also done. We have chosen mutating points as hands and legs. Of course, this is also after several experimentation, that if we use mutation for head or if we use it for waist, was it giving you different combination or something unique or something different? So after all that, we restricted only to hand and leg positions.
So,
and leg instead of for all other, yeah, because we didn't get very good outputs if we were doing. Yes, okay. So the proposed fitness function was based on a distance from the adipose, because we wanted to keep the classical approach and not deviate completely and give something new dance position. We didn't want that. And we designed a fitness function with these two parameters, the limb variation count and the absolute vector difference. I'll explain to you what they are. So basically, we designed the fitness function with reference to 2 weights, and we tried different weights, and we came across that this experimentally, that these 2 weights were giving very good results.
Did you see that?
No, afterwards. No, we will show you this. Yeah, this it is here only. You want back?
Okay.
Experimental basis to see how the results are looking. While, yeah, selecting different 0.5, 0.5, keeping equal weights 0.6, 0.4, 0.8,
0.5.
Plenty now, rest. Next. So, no, I will explain, no, before this. No, to explain that absolute vector difference. Next. Yes, this is to explain the limb variation count. So if D1 and D2 are 2 different 30 attribute vectors, and we have to find the limb variation count. So if you see the first 2 positions marked in red in D1 and D2, those are the head positions. So the limb variation count is calculated as if there is a difference between them. There is no difference, they are the same. So the limb variation count is 0. That's how we have calculated. So when it says 5 limb variation count, that means 5 of the limb positions are different. That's what it means. And absolute vector difference, calculate the absolute. Okay? And then calculate normal distribution for that, so that we get the curve and we calculate the fitness function. And now select and find the 10 fittest out of these using this. Next. So now after getting these results, all these results are coming in the output form of vectors, which is very, very difficult to interpret. So we use that stick figure that we will show, if time permits, we'll show that octave program, which stick figures were used. Then we used expert rankings to find out whether these outputs, we explained the stick figures to the dance teachers, and now we ask them to rank. So this is a very manual and a tedious task. But our output was only to see whether we could generate what we were looking at. So we didn't pay much attention to that. We also used the mean opinion score method to find out whether this pose which we are generating through the system could be a starting pose to give unique choreographic movement. This was the idea. Next. So, next.
Then what about the one gesture is greater and around with the
to fire the imagination of the choreographer if the starting pose is different and something unique. That we are coming, multi-beat choreography. So initially we experimented for single beat choreography. There is no single beat actually choreography, but we wanted to generate
one instance of that.
Yes, to see whether it is doable, plausible or not, and then generate multiple beat. So the automatic classification of these generate. No, prior to this there is one more, I think so. Okay, fine, put this. So we took dance experts' opinion and used various tools for automatic classification of the poses. And it was something like this. We gave picture number because we gave the vectors to a dance teacher and we asked her to pose and we clicked those pictures. And then we had the picture numbers and we had several experts and we asked them to rank the poses from a scale, Likert scale of 1 to 5. What is their opinion? Yeah. We noticed that domain experts are not always consistent. And it was a very, very time. No, we tried that also, Kappa statistics also, but it didn't.
Let's assume that they were on the same college.
Yeah, yesterday when, day before when I presented my paper, I mentioned these, that most of the researchers or dance teachers whom we thought of big repute were telling one particular pose were bad. And I thought it was really bad, till I met one dance teacher who is not known to be very, very well renowned or something, and she took up and she looked at the pose. I didn't mention to her that everyone is saying this is a very bad pose. Everyone had told that bad. But she took that pose and she said this is a very innovative and creative pose. And she danced and she showed me. I didn't even ask her to do.
That is possible. That's what I demonstrated this
week. Correct. Absolutely. But this in 2012, I didn't know that, right? So I assumed that whatever the dance teachers were saying were correct. And but she looked at it and she said this is very innovative and very different, and she danced and showed me, you know, and she said whatever poses you are generating can be used as innovative choreography because it is firing my imagination. So that set me thinking that we could automate always. It depends maybe on the time, mood, work pressure, always, which adds on to it, and they are not consistent with theirs, because I'm so sure if it, after 10 days I show them, it might change or it might not, I'm not sure. So I would have to run experiments again to do, what was their mood at that time?
No, you can say at least 1%.